What's up, ghouls and gals? It's me, Ryan.T here, and good fucking morning. Well, good morning if you're watching this live right now. If you're watching this later, good afternoon. Good night. How are you doing? And it's nice to see you. Hell yeah, man. I'm happy to be back with another episode in 2024. I was going to say the first episode of 2024, but me and the main man, Sid Retro, knocked that one out earlier in the year. And speaking of the main man, he'll be back on later in the week. Well, actually, tomorrow I think we're going to record another episode, so you can expect the Ryan.T, Sid Retro combo to be back this weekend. But without further ado, ghouls and gals, I wanted to give y'all a little news episode. So much shit has happened this week. The Golden Globes happened, you know, Mia Goth kicked somebody in the fucking head. So many things fucking happened, and I wanted to share it with you, ghouls and gals. Wanted to recap it with you all. But before we get into all that fucking awesome shit, I just wanted to know, how are y'all doing? How are y'all doing this morning, this night, whenever you're watching this? Let me know in the comments below, because like I always say at the Ryan.T Show podcast, we care. But yeah, ghouls and gals, it feels good to be back. Thanks for tuning in. If you're tuning in right now, make sure you like, drop a comment, all that good fucking shit. It really helps out the show when you do that. But yeah, let's get right into the fucking news, man. Our first story of the day or the morning is Martin Scorsese is making a film about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. And here are the details for the film. It's going to have an 80-minute runtime. It's going to be his shortest movie ever. Says it's mostly in the present day. And it says that his point of the movie is to remove the negative association with organized religion. Wonder why people have that. And production's going to start later this year. I guess that sounds cool. I mean, whatever. He's probably going to have Leonardo DiCaprio play fucking Jesus Christ or some shit like that, and have like Robert De Niro play the devil, and they're both going to be in this interlocked battle to fuck over some Native American race. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, that would be interesting to see Scorsese, one, do a short film that's only like fucking an hour 30 minutes, hour 20 minutes long, and then two, to see him take on the fucking Jesus, you know what I mean? I just saw a movie about Jesus recently. I saw The Book of Clarence, which you can check out my review for that film and on all my social media pages. But Book of Clarence was really cool. So if it's anything like the Scorsese movie, or the Scorsese movie is anything like that movie, it's gonna be fucking good. It's also Scorsese's a fucking goat, man, you know what I mean? After watching Killers of the Flower Moon, that shit was reaffirmed to me, you know what I mean? I was like, talk all your shit, old man, I mean, you still got the fucking juice, you know what I mean? But I just hope this movie isn't like a fucking corny like religious recruitment film where it's just like him talking, you know what I mean, him trying to convert us into Christianity for fucking 90 minutes or whatever, because I'm not down with that. I don't want to fucking watch that shit. I don't want a Sound of Freedom fucking part two or anything like that. But if Martin Scorsese can get it done, he's the one that could get it done. I just think it's weird that he's going to make it super short. Maybe that's a response to our like fucking decaying fucking attention spans, man. Like, Jesus Christ. Like, I feel like people can't like just sit and watch a fucking movie anymore. They're like, oh, what? It's 2 hours? Nope, can't watch that. It's too fucking long. Like, what the fuck? That's just how long movies are. You know what I mean? Like, movies can't be 30 fucking minutes. That's a TV episode. But yeah, speaking of short attention spans, did y'all... Okay. The fucking... The 25th anniversary for The Sopranos happened this week. And I was on fucking TikTok, as, you know, everybody else is while they're at work. And I was on TikTok, you know what I mean? And I followed the HBO... TikTok page and the Sopranos page. I'm one of those fucking guys, you know what I mean? So I saw that the Sopranos posted this fucking, I saw that they started to post all these videos, all these TikToks. And I was like, why are they posting so many fucking TikToks? And I saw that they started to fucking put their episodes into bite-sized little 25-second long TikToks. And I was just like, what the fuck? Hell no. You do not do that to the fucking Sopranos. You are not gonna fucking condense a whole entire episode of groundbreaking HBO fucking TV into fucking 25 fucking seconds in a fucking vertical aspect ratio. Are you fucking crazy? Tony Soprano just can't fit in a fucking little fucking aspect ratio like that. Are you fucking nuts? What the fuck? That is fucking, that should be fucking illegal. That should be fucking illegal to do that. What the fucking shit? And when I saw that, that actually fucking pissed me off. I was like, this is fucking bullshit. You know what I mean? Just, I'll post a minute clip. You can post up to 10 minute long videos on fucking TikTok. Why not post a fucking minute clip of like some of the best scenes of the fucking series? Instead, you're gonna put condense whole episodes into 25 fucking seconds? Are you fucking crazy? There was a fucking Mad TV skit about that where they had to cut out like all the curse words and it ended up being like a 25 second episode. So that's just wow. Like, I don't know how they can fucking do that. You know what I mean? That shit's so annoying. Warner Brothers continuously just does the fucking most annoying, stupid fucking shit when it comes to their fucking properties. And I fucking hate it. I'm about to go fucking boycott Warner Brothers for the fucking bullshit that they've been fucking pulling with that fucking crap. But yeah, man. Speaking of crap and the devil... The Exorcist Believer was a bad movie, as we can all agree to. The Exorcist Believer, directed by David Gordon Green, that movie was so bad that we can now say that it fucking tanked an entire franchise. The Exorcist Deceiver, which was going to be the sequel to the 2023 film, has lost its release date and its director. David Gordon Green is no longer going to direct the sequel, nor will the sequel be coming out on April 2025. So, yeah. Usually when that happens, that's not fucking good. That means that your movie's not coming out anymore. So, yeah. I don't think they're going to give it another release date. I don't think they're going to give it another director. I think they just kind of are going to just do something else. I think they're just going to do something else. And that sucks, man, because I like The Exorcist. I wanted this to fucking work. I wanted to have like a couple of more modern day Exorcist movies. But after seeing this fucking movie, what the fuck, man? This guy, David Gordon Green, does not need to be around any more legacy horror movie franchises. He totally fucked up Halloween with that Halloween Ends, and it looks like he ended the Exorcist franchise. You can believe that. But yeah, fuck, man. It sucks to see another good horror franchise bite the dust, but looks like we're not going to see another Exorcist movie for a good long while. But speaking of movies that are going to be getting sequels, Top Gun 3 is currently in the works with Tom Cruise. According to multiple sources, the script for the film is already being written, and of course it's going to be coming out with Paramount. That's Tom Cruise's that's his fucking home, Paramount. But yeah, Top Gun 3, apparently they want to get the same directors. They want to get Jerry Bruckheimer to produce, and they also want to get all of the same cast back together and stuff like that. But according to this, Tom Cruise won't be available to film till like 2026 or 2027. Tom Cruise is, how old is Tom Cruise right now? Tom Cruise has to be like in his 60s, right? Tom Cruise is 61, so we're in 2024 right now. Tom Cruise will be in his mid-60s by the time that they want to do fucking Top Gun 3. They're going to have to wheel him out in a fucking stretcher to fly in that fucking plane. The G-Force is going to break his fucking jaw off. I mean, admittedly, Tom Cruise looks like 40 years old, but I mean, my boy's getting up there in age. If they're going to make that Top Gun movie, they need to make it now. Make it now and make it snappy. But it's a no-brainer that they're going to do a Top Gun 3. Top Gun the Top Gun Maverick fucking saved the fucking global box office during the fucking pandemic. You know what I mean? It's crazy. I was just talking about this the other day. It's crazy to think that Top Gun, a movie that was based on 1980s nostalgia, saved the box office. Yes, nostalgia sells, but, you know, not that many people cared about Top Gun anymore. You know what I mean? So it was just very interesting to me that this film had that amount of fucking impact and that amount of influence and was actually a good fucking movie. Sure, it's a fucking divorced dad movie, but it is fucking amazing. Top Gun Maverick is such a great fucking film. Such an anomaly. Such a fucking comment of a fucking movie that I don't think will happen again for some time. And speaking of movies that aren't going to be happening for some time, Maxine, we have a little bit of update on the movie Maxine that I've personally been waiting for, starring Mia Goth there. And it's not the update that you would have thought I'd be giving you. Apparently, Mia Goth is being sued for allegedly kicking a background actor named James Hunter in the head on the set of Maxine, and she allegedly taunted and mocked him and belittled him, daring him to do anything about it. And that to me just seems like fucking hilarious. If any of y'all have heard Mia Goth like really talk in real life, she sounds like a fucking British mouse. So her being like, "Oh yeah, what are you gonna do about it, you little bitch? Yeah, I kicked you in your fucking noggin. What are you gonna say? What are you gonna do? I'm Mia fucking Goth." It's just like fucking super hilarious to me. Or if she was like in character, like as Pearl, and she just like violently grabbed that guy from like the cufflinks and she's like, "I'm a star! I'm gonna be a star!" And like started like shaking him, that would have been fucking awesome. But I don't know. I mean, she's going to be sued. They're going to go to court and all that. And I don't know if this is going to impact the release date of Maxine or whatever, or if this is going to impact her career or anything like that. But I don't know. For some reason, maybe I'm biased or something like that. But for some reason, I just don't buy it. I just don't feel like it's true. I feel like maybe this guy's just trying to get a fucking payday or something. Or maybe it is true. Maybe she did kick the fuck out of this guy in the fucking head and was just like, "Motherfucker." Pfft. Apparently he was laying on the floor and he's laying on the floor in the scene that he's in with her, and she has to walk over him and like look down, and apparently she had been like bumping into him, and he like complained to somebody and was like, "Hey, can you tell her to like, you know, ease up a little bit? She's been bumping into me and, you know, it kind of hurts," or whatever. And I guess she got mad that guy complained about her and was just like, "Motherfucker, I'm really gonna bump into you." And so she fucking stomped his fucking head and kicked him and shit. Allegedly. We don't know if that happened. I'm not trying to get fucking sued by anybody. But I don't know, man. I just don't fucking, I don't know. I don't believe it. I don't feel like this chick over here is like stomping anybody in the fucking head. You know what I mean? I don't know. She seems like a kind of a nice person. Or maybe she's a fucking super bitch. I don't know. I don't know her personally. I mean, you know what I mean? But I don't know. It kind of feels a little sketchy. Little sketchy Johnson. It feels like this James Hunter dude is kind of trying to get like a payday or something. I don't know. I guess we'll wait and see what happens with the Mia Goth James Hunter trial and see if Mia Goth did in fact stomp this fucking dude's head out. But yeah, ghouls and gals. Speaking of things that make me want to stomp my head out, 21 Savage is making a movie about the time he got deported back to his homeland of England. The film is titled American Dream, the 21 Savage story, and it will star Donald Glover and Stranger Things actor Caleb McLaughlin. It will hit theaters on Independence Day. Let's check out the trailer. Let's see what 21 has cooking for us. Let me get that trailer started right here. Oh, wait, what the fuck am I doing? All right, hold on. I was like, "Where's the trailer?" And I was like, "Dumbass, you have to start the fucking trailer." Hold on. Bear with me. It's a live show. All right. 3, 2, 1, boom.
All right.
Oh, Donald Glover looks fucking ridiculous as 21 Savage. These people, they think we're savages. What is this? I already kind of don't like this. Twenty-One Savage looks so goofy to me. I don't know why, he just does. He looks like a fucking Batman villain. He looks like he's gonna hold Gotham City hostage. Yeah, I don't like this. I'm assuming this is gonna be like a long music video. Also, speaking of long, this fucking trailer is fucking 4 minutes long. Is this gonna be some R. Kelly trapped in the closet shit? 21 Savage gonna be trapped in the closet? It's okay, step out. Pussy. He always has to add that in everything. Pussy. Why is Drewski in this? Drewski's wearing a fucking Oreos jacket. Is this just a music video? Is this for real just like a music video? Oh my god, that looks ridiculous. That looks ridiculous! What the fuck? Donald Glover makes everything look so fucking goofy. I like Donald Glover, but he makes everything look so fucking goofy. What the fuck is this? He looks like a space pimp. This has to be like a joke, right? Like a comedy thing? Like it's like a bit? He's doing a bit? What the fuck? Did he explode? Was his mixtape that fire? This looks so fucking like I'm 14 and this is deep. You know what I mean? Like I feel like every middle school kid's gonna watch this and they're gonna be like, "Oh, that movie was so hardcore, so deep." This fucking chick is in the movie now too. What in the world? They didn't give me a name.
Dude, that's like savages. That's it. That's your name. Twenty-one Savage. Yeah. I like that.
What the fuck? What? What the fuck was that? That looked fucking ridiculous. What? That had to have been a joke, right? That's a joke. That felt like that was like an episode of like the Boondocks or like that felt like... Nah, that wasn't real, right? No. What are you doing, 21? 21, 21. God, what the fuck was that? That was ridiculous. That's not a real thing. What? Yeah, I guess. That's going to be coming out on Independence Day. The 21 Savage movie, American Dream, 21 Savage. Man, whoa, that was weird. I mean, I don't... I think the funny part is that he's taking it so seriously, but it's comes he's taking it so seriously that it comes off silly and stupid and dumb. Like, it... Like, he's taking it so seriously that it just comes off dumb. Like, and he's like... And then, like, you have fucking Donald Glover, like, like, looking like a space pimp. And then you got the little fucking Stranger Things boy just, like, hanging out. And, like, what the fuck is this? This looks like crazy, man. This looks insane. And he's like, they don't give me a name. Only gave me 21. Figure they savages. What the fuck? That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. That's... I can't wait to watch that. I'm definitely 100% gonna watch that in Independence Day. I'm gonna watch that, review it, then pop some fireworks, get drunk, and bump some 21 Savage all night long, because holy shit, this movie looks like it has the potential to be, like, The Room level bad. Like, so bad that it's good. Like, that for generations it's gonna, like, fuel us to be, like, so bad that it's good. I cannot wait to watch this. I hope it comes out in theaters. I hope I can watch this in a movie theater, because that'll be fucking epic to watch this, like, ginormous, hilarious movie in a movie theater. Oh, God. Let me know what y'all think about the 21 Savage movie in the comments below, or if you're a fan of 21 Savage. I think this looks hilariously bad, like, but in the best way possible. Like, I cannot wait to watch this amazingly bad movie. Moving on to the next... trailer. The next trailer we got is the Amy Winehouse trailer, Back to Black, the Amy Winehouse biopic. I was kind of interested in this movie, man. I mean, I know Amy Winehouse is kind of like a cult figure in movies. I mean, in music, you know what I mean? She has like cult status, and a lot of people are interested in this and this biopic, namely the cast for this biopic. The actress they picked to play Amy Winehouse doesn't really look like Amy Winehouse a whole lot. And so I know a lot of people are kind of like fucking like, you know, like about that. But yeah, I guess we'll find out right now. We're going to check out the first official trailer for Back to Black, the Amy Winehouse movie, directed by Sam Taylor Johnson, coming out May 10th, 2024. Let's get that bad boy rolling. Also, let me know in the comments below, are you a fan of Amy Winehouse? Do you like her? Do you like her music? I'll say her movies. All right, boom. Here we go. I don't write songs to be famous. I write songs. She sounds like her. Oh, no, she does not look like her at all. Yeah, she doesn't look like her at all. She's like a very, like, cutesy version of Amy Winehouse. Amy Winehouse, like, had, like, a very, like, rough, like, look. You know what I mean? I want people to hear my voice. That guy looks like Flea from the Red Hot Chili Peppers. And just forget their troubles. You gotta remember, I ain't no Spice Girl. I ain't no Spice Girl. This movie better be rated R. Okay, I think it is gonna be. She has the hair. I wanna be remembered for just being me. But yeah, she does not look like Amy Winehouse at all. Show the rating. What's the rating? Is it rated R? Oh, they didn't show the fucking rating, these fuckers. But yeah, it better be rated R. That movie better be fucking rated R. If it's not rated R, it's gonna be some fucking bullshit. I hate when every one of these fucking Every one of these, like, celebrity, like, movie biopics, they need to be rated R. They have to be rated R. You cannot tell the story of somebody like an Amy Winehouse or Elvis Presley or, you know, Queen or whatever, David Bowie, whatever, and it not be rated R. So hopefully this movie is rated R. It looks like it's going to be rated R. It looks like they show her strung out on, like, drugs and stuff like that, which unfortunately was a part of Amy Winehouse's career and life and stuff like that. But, ghouls and gals, it looks like they're going to be kind of doing her story, but I can see how fans of Amy Winehouse are kind of just like, no, she does not look like fucking Amy Winehouse. She looks like a very, like, cutesy version of Amy Winehouse. But, I mean, the movie doesn't look too bad, you know what I mean? I'm going to check it out, see what's going on with that. It's coming out pretty soon, May 10th, 2024, Back to Black, starring Marissa Abella and Jack O'Connell as Blake Fielder, Amy Winehouse's longtime lover and, I think, husband, right? I think they were married. But, yeah, let me know in the comments below if you're going to check that one out. But, yeah, ghouls and gals, that's all the news we have for today. Hopefully you enjoyed this quick little bite-sized news episode. I wanted to keep it, like, under 30, no more than 40, you know what I mean? But let me know what you thought about this news episode, and if you want me to continue doing these a little Friday morning or Friday afternoon type thing, let me know in the comments below. And like always, I'm Ryan.T. Thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. I'll see you in the next one.